was Clemson and I believe Duke played, or I can't remember who the teams were, but Clemson. And they pointed out that their beautiful football facilities they just built was state of the art. So I asked the guy, what did something like that run? Oh man, they're ducking $60, $70 million. I said, oh really? How long did it take them to get the money? Oh God, no problem. And with that, months, no problem at all. Yet now I'm begging and pleading, trying to save kids' lives like Tony Coleman's not with us to get $3.5 million. Are you kidding me? Where are our priorities? Where are our priorities? I'm selfish. I have five healthy grandkids. It would crush me. I've heard stories here. I see Kyle Peters sitting there. Kyle, stand up, Kyle. Kyle's been with us for years. Kyle was 11 years old, came down with brain cancer. And it was tough what he faced. And he battled and battled. Today he's cancer-free. He's going to college this September. He will start. Kyle can't do enough to raise dollars. But you know how this thing started? With a headache. A headache that a mother says, take some aspirin. You'll be fine. I see kids out here, you in sarcoma, pain in the foot. Where's Colton Courtney? Where's Colton? There's Colton ready to look cool with that hat on, man. I like it. Like it live. Last day of school. Am I right? The last day of school, you find out pain in your foot. Little do you know, it turns out to be Ewan sarcoma, an incredible battle with cancer. I think about Tatum Parker. I know she's in the house, so where's Tatum? Stand up, Tatum. Tatum's been with us for about 70 years. Tatum, till this day, Tatum has bags of fun. She fills up bags. She gets people like me to send gifts, and people all over give her gifts. Puts it in those bags, and every time a child registers in Indianapolis and Osceola for children with cancer, the first thing they get is a visit, and Tatum with a bag of fun for them. And she's battled cancer twice for sarcoma. She's a winner, man. These kids are winners. These kids are dreams of coaches. They're coaching because they're so courageous and so tough. I was teaching Joshua, he was thinking to root for opening game. Michigan won Notre Dame. Last year he's at the
Notre Dame. I got a feeling.
Uh-oh, you got a feeling? You mean on the Michigan sideline? Come on now. Where are you going to be? No. We'll put you on a spot. Michigan or Notre Dame? What?
You're from Michigan.
Come on, Josh. We're going to talk.
Hey, seriously, there's one thing I want to close with. This gets me emotional, boy. I hope I don't. I went to the hospital to visit last year at our gala. Many of you kids were here. Tony Coleman was here. Tony Coleman always had a smile on his face. He developed a relationship that was unbelievable with the Lightning. I just got here, they're playing their first game today, the Lightning. John Cooper sent me a text message today. And John Cooper sent in a text message to Coach. He said, Dick, as you know, if I didn't have this game tonight, where I would be. He said, keep doing what you're doing, man. Please understand how much Tony meant to me. We had a big event up in Tampa that he put on to raise money, and have me as the speaker, and Tony was one of the honored guests. Tony, last year at my house at the post-gala party we have for the celebrities on Saturday and the cancer kids here, Tony spoke so brilliantly, if you remember. And he said in that speech, what stood out to me, he said he was a kid not being selfish. He was battling for his life. After 6 years of battling, winning the battle, it's in remission, not in remission, in remission. Every time I see him, a smile on his face. One time we were at the baseball game, and Doug, I knew you were at the game. At the baseball game, to see the Orioles were training here in Sarasota, and he comes running over to my wife and I. I said, how you doing, Tony? You look great. And he said, well, I wish I could tell you that, Mr. V. He said, they tell me the cancer's come back again and spreading all over. At a baseball game. And I said, Tony, you'll be like, oh, I'm not worried about me, man. He's always just keep raising money, help kids. And I tell you, when he spoke in my house, it stood out to me when he said to everybody there. He said, look, I may not win my battle. Please help these kids, man. They need dollars. Well, I went to the hospital to visit him last June. My wife and I go to the hospital, right out alive, just brought me to tears, laying in bed with tubes all over. Morphine to kill the pain was sitting there, and I vowed to him as I sat in the bed. I said, oh, Tony, I promise you, to my last breath, feel like I got the energy of a 25-year-old. There's nothing to stop me from begging and pleading. Sometimes even aggravated some of the CEOs and people, because I just keep coming after them and after them. I don't want to go after people that don't have money. But God Almighty, if you got money, how could you not give? If you've got a healthy child, it could change tomorrow. I saw my agent, Susan. Where are you, Susan? I know you're here. We were in Dallas. We were at a hospital.